G'day, I'm Luke from Drifter, and this afternoon I wanted to show you one of the kitchen packages we have for the trailers. I've got here the .7 camper, and it's just a good chance to show you our DPO package deal, which we've been making for a long time, but I've done some upgrades to it, and we haven't done a video before of our Drifter pullout package deal kitchen. So this is a 7x4 trailer. Okay, very common, you know, most trailers on the market are a 7x4. Now, the best way to access your gear inside the trailer is with a storage box and a pull-out kitchen. Okay, so that's the storage box there, and the kitchen that runs alongside it. You can have a swing-out tailgate kitchen, but the tailgate kitchen takes up this front space, and it does make it hard to access the space behind that. Now, with the DPO package deal, we've got three different sections. The first is the tucker box, okay, and that pulls out just a box. Really what this is to take up that little bit of space there. Okay, the thing is with the kitchen's 6 foot long, but it folds out an extra foot when you fold it out, and the awnings are sort of 8 foot long, so we can't make a kitchen really any longer than this, otherwise it comes out past the awning. So that's why the kitchen is generally 6 foot long, the trailer is 7 foot long, and the remaining space we take up with the tucker box. But it's a very handy box. Okay, it's just you know, for putting fruits and vegetables in. You know, the kids can sit on it. Got a little lid there that folds over like that. Put some newspaper in the bottom. It's a very handy box. You can also use that like a step, you know, say if you want to do up the awning on the trailer for the tent poles. So you can use it like a step as well. It's very strong. You can see here as well with the storage box and the kitchen, this is what we call our black stainless look. So we've got a stainless laminate over the top of the ply. Okay, and then we blacken all the edges as well. So that is what our new modern look, which is we call black stainless. The storage box just pulls out very easily, and once it gets more than halfway, you can counterbalance this on the bed base like that, so there's no legs underneath it that you need to use. All this space inside the trailer is now transferred out here where you can get to it. Okay, so you can fill this right up with all of your gear, and of course you can get to it very easily. If you want to pull the storage box out further, you can do that with the legs here. Okay, they're all adjustable, so you can pull it out, as you can see, 90% of the way. Now this version here, this is what we call just the dividers, and this customer's asked for three separate dividers, so they can just screw in here, you know, wherever you think you need them. The trick as well, when you're putting it away, is just push it away, say halfway, so the weight's not on the box here. And you can do the legs like that. Now the other thing as well is this is running on these pieces of Teflon. Okay, I've only been doing this for about 12 months, and that's the Teflon there. You can see it's 6mm Teflon strips that we just rivet down with some countersunk pop rivets, and you can see how well that slides on the floor of the trailer. So now we're sliding like our drawers, Teflon on Teflon, and that's a very good system. So if you wanted to get the runners, they'll be on the website, and you can just select those as well. Then all you need to do is just rivet those down. So a lot of trailers will have a checker plate floor, all different types of floors, and this does two things. It will protect the floor of the trailer, so you know you're not scratching the paint off, and also it means that the storage box is going to slide much nicer. You can see how well that is in fact sliding. So that works really well. In the front of the storage box we've got our pantry drawers as well. So we call this the storage box with front drawers, and you can just see those there. So these are great as a pantry, so you can pull your storage box out a little way, you can use that top space there for bench space, and you've got these drawers here. Now the kitchen comes out as well, so again slides really nicely, pull it out halfway, legs drop down. Now just kind of pull it out about to where the edge of this hinges, which means we've still got about 6 inches left inside the trailer. If you want to put a bit of a rope, we do have a stopper kit there that you can hook up so that it pulls out to a paracord stopper and it won't come all the way out. This one hasn't got the second set of legs, but you can get them with a second set of legs so that you can then use that freestanding, and you can set it up anywhere if you want to. Now this one here is what we call the DPO. Again, it just stands for Drifter Pullout, so it's one of our more simple pullout kitchens. It doesn't have the big return on it. Okay, I've got this small piece on the end. Right, so that folds up like that, and the lid here lifts up. In the space here we've got our stove, and this is a new stove bag as well, so I'll show you that. You know, the stove in that area, it just sits there like that. It's really nice to have this new bag they're doing. It's a bootliner bag, and that just fits nicely in there like that, so it can't move and can't, you know, it can't move around and scratch things. And it just slides in there like that, so. Okay, so then there's your stove fits there. Alright, so that's our new stove bags. We're doing those for the two burner Primus high output, the single burner stoves, the dual burner butane stoves, you know, quite a few. So that's really nice. So the stove's there, this front section drops down and you pull out your sink area. Now on this DPO black stainless package deal, we'll have one of these red tubs as standard. These are the new collapsible tubs, they're really good. So it's great to be able to have two tubs rather than just the one. There's your pump there, so you can pump all your water up into your washing up dish. You can still wash up over here or anywhere you like on top. And again, these collapsible tubs, you know, just work really well. It's really good quality silicone, and they work great. Inside here you've got plenty of room for your cookware, fry pan underneath or a chopboard, and you've got the three drawers here as well. Cutlery, this is good for plates and cups, and, you know, further space down here as well. So that's where we call, when we're constructing the kitchen, this is the H-piece area. You can see there why we call it the H piece, and that sort of forms the structure as part of the kitchen. With the DPO in the black stainless look, we've got the push button latches, which is really nice. Okay, just finishes it off well. And on the end here we've got a cupboard, so there's lots of room in there for just, you know, more food or, you know, kitchen equipment. So nice cupboard on the end. The reason we've got a cupboard here and not drawers is because the storage box can slide out, and because we've got the hinge moved in about 6 inches from the end, we can still open up that cupboard even though some of the kitchen is sitting inside the trailer. Okay, so you can see if you lift this here up, you can still pull your storage box right out to access it. Although keep in mind, once you've set up your camp, half of the things that was in the storage box will now be out and you'll be using them, such as chairs and tables and things. So you normally wouldn't have to get right into the back of the storage box. You just want to open it up about halfway to get things, and the back of it would be empty anyway. Okay, to pack the kitchen up, very simple. You know, once you've done the washing up and you've finished your meal, you can put everything away just like your kitchen at home. Okay. Again, the trick is to push it just halfway. Alright, so there's no weight on the legs. Pile them up. That slides away and the tucker box comes in. And that's all packed up. It's very easy. On the trailers now, on our trailers, the Dot 7 Camper, we've got this piece of aluminium strip here. Okay, because what holds these boxes in place is the tailgate closes up against these. The Teflon strips here and here will lock against the tailgate, and there's no forward and back movement. So we've just got that plate there to stop rubbing and scratching on the tailgate. If you wanted to order a package like this, there's a couple of things we need to know. One is which side is the kitchen on. Now, this one is a right hand side tailgate, so the kitchen's going to sit on the driver's side. Just as many trailers are the opposite, so they've got a left hand swinging tailgate, so the hinges are on the left hand side, and that'd be a left hand side. So you need to let us know, is the kitchen going to sit on the driver's side or the passenger side? Then also you need to let us know the dimensions of the trailer. So we just need an accurate dimension of the width of the trailer, the height here, and then the length. It's important also, with this tailgate here, as you can see when you close it, it closes flush against the tailgate and doesn't protrude inside. Quite a lot of tailgates are made so that when you close them, part of the tailgate protrudes inside the trailer. Okay, so if If your target is like that, you need to allow for that in your measurement. So yeah, if you can just let us know, driver side, passenger side, the three dimensions of your trailer, and when we can make this package deal up for you, freight it to you anywhere in Australia, and literally you can just slide it straight into your trailer. The package deal comes with a packer in the middle, okay, so that's standard, that's a timber packer there. I'll just show you this again. Okay, so the Teflon strips are an extra, but you do get this packer, which you can screw down into the floor of your trailer. So generally you'd do three holes from underneath the trailer and screw that down from underneath, okay? And that's what separates the kitchen and the storage box. So it's very quick and easy to fit, take you 10 minutes. If you wanted to buy the Teflon runners as well, then it'll take a little bit longer, but that will make a better finish. Rightio, so that's our DPO, a Drifter pull-out black stainless package deal. This has got the option of the front drawers in the storage box. We've got the Teflon runners in the trailer. We've got the red stove and the two red tubs as well. So you can select all that on the website if you like. Now I've got some other trailers here as well. They've all got different setups in them. So while we're talking about kitchens and storage boxes, I'll just show you a couple of things there as well. Rightio. Okay, so I've got three trailers here in our backyard this afternoon as well. This is our new 5-foot equip trailer. I've got a 6 equip and also the new 7 equip. So we'll do another quick video shortly and show you those. But I do have some different storage box setups in each one, so I wanted to show you those. So this is the little 5-foot equip, okay? And what we've got in here is just two storage boxes. So this is how a standard storage box looks like. There's no front drawers in them, just an open storage box. Same sort of thing. Pull it out, you can counterbalance it on the back of the trailer. You can use the legs as well. Just a couple of things I wanted to show you. See how those legs are adjustable? So you can set those up any sort of ground. Okay. So this storage box has got a table sort of built into the top of it. And it's just sitting on this little rail here. You can see that. That's got a Teflon strip, about 12mm square, that we screw onto the side of the storage box. We've got a couple of buttons here to stop it moving forward and back. And that lets you fit this table on top. Okay, these are our tables that we make. We're selling a lot of these. It's a 600 by 900 or 600 by 1200mm table. 12mm ply with a laminated top. And of course our leg system. You can't really buy a better table than that. Of course, it's got all adjustable legs, and you can set that up, you know, up to nearly 1100 high, or set it down low for sitting at. It's just a really good spot to sit them on top of the storage box like that. The width of trailers varies quite a bit, and our kitchen is a standard 460 wide, so the storage box takes up whatever room is left. So all the storage boxes are slightly different dimensions. And for that reason, the table needs to be made exactly to suit as well. So if you've got already a storage box from us, all you need to do is measure the inside width here, let us know, and we can make a table exactly to fit, and then we can also provide you with these runners, which you can easily screw onto the side of the storage box. So yeah, that works really good. Again, these tables are great, especially for camping with your trailer. And it just makes a great little spot for it, fitting in on top there like that. The other thing you can see here as well is a pole carrier. We're starting to do a lot of those now too. So it's just basically a box that's built into the top of the storage box, and you can see there all of your tent poles. They just fit nice and neatly down inside there like that. You know, tent poles on the trail is a little bit of a hassle where to carry them. Most people, of course, have them across the front of the trailer, but sometimes that box in the front is not quite wide enough for your long pole, and you know, it just takes up room that you could use otherwise for a lot of other things, jerry cans and things like that. So this works quite well. Again, if you've already got a box, we can make something like that for you. You can see how it's still got the divider, but we've just done a cutout in there so that fits underneath there. So you've still got your divider that can screw in there wherever you like. Pole carrier's there, and the table just fits up on top. OK, Okay, you see how that just fits perfect length on the little runners. On this side here, what we've got is another storage box. This is going to be our 5 foot equipped trailer. So we've already got a kitchen in the vehicle, in the 76. So we don't need to pull a kitchen out of the back of this trailer. But I'll put the fridge in here. So that's just the little 47 litre Evercool. It's got a separate freezer. And we've only just finished this trailer recently. But that gives a fridge just at the back of the trailer here. I've still got quite a bit of room in behind that for food. Okay, and it's all plugged in. And if we're camping, we can just leave this storage box sitting there like that. The fridge is easy to access. We've got our Snap-Pick fire pit sitting out here, which we do a lot of our cooking on. And I can lift the little kitchen out of my vehicle and just set it up along here. So that's a great little setup. If I need to get anything out of the box, of course, I can just pull it out really easily. On this trailer as well, the awning will wrap around 270 degrees, so that'll cover all of this area. Okay, on this 6 foot equip, alright, so this is again another open storage box, standard box. This one is a second hand trailer, no drawers in the front, just a nice carpet lined box, lots of room for all your gear. This kitchen here is our pull out with return kitchen, and it's also got the little drop down in the back here, as you can see. Now if you've got a trailer that's quite high, you can get this option of the little cutout on the back, which drops it down about an inch. You can see here how we can adjust the legs. Right. So you can use those, of course, to level up the kitchen on any ground. This is the standard kitchen we put with our dock campers, which is the return setup. And you can see here how we've also got a small drop down there, so that return is not quite as high, okay? So if you're not quite, you know, if you're not so tall, or if you've got a high trailer, you can have both these two options as well on any of the kitchens that we make. So you can option for a small cutout on the back, which when you pull the kitchen out, it drops down, and also a little bit lower bench space, which we can do a drop here, no problems at all. So you just need to let us know if you want us to do that. So this is our pull-out with return kitchen. We've shown you that before. That's got all the nice bench space. It's exactly the same really as the kitchen we've shown you before, the DPO, but this has got also the return section. Quickly put that away. You can see how quick and easy it is, just slides away like that. Because this is only a 6 foot trailer and not the 7, this kitchen takes up the full amount of space inside the trailer. This one over here is a 7 foot equipped trailer. Okay, so we've been doing a few of these recently, and I'm going to do a little. We've been doing a few of these recently, and they're going really well. That's got the large canopy. The 7 foot trailer, so it's the same trailer base as our camper, but it's just got the equipped top on it with the big canopy. You can see here also it's got the storage box with front drawers, okay, to use as a pantry, and it's also got the pole carrier and the table in there. Because this is a longer box, adjust those legs. because this has got the longer box, we've also got the bigger table. And you can see that there, that's a 1200mm table, so it's a lot longer than the one we had in the little 5 equip. So we can make these tables up to 1200mm long. And this one here's got the same kitchen as the 6 foot, which is the DPOR, the drifter pull-out with return kitchen. You can see we've got that bit of extra space, so the tucker box just goes in there like that, and you can close the tailgate, it's all locked up. Okay, so there's a look at our DPO package steel kitchen, and also some of the options we can do with the storage box. So again, all you need to do is measure up your trailer. We can build these up and send them anywhere in Australia. Just need to know the trailer dimensions, left or right, where the kitchen's sitting, and you can email those details through. It takes us about 2 to 3 weeks to get one of these kitchens made, and about a week for freight as well. So if you're going away sometime, make sure you give us plenty of notice, and we'll get it done for you as soon as we can. It all comes completely finished, all wrapped up in a box, and all you've got to do is unwrap it and slide it into the trailer. Okay, thanks very much.